In this video, we will discuss two important concepts, EVSI and EVPI. EVSI stands for Expected Value of Sample Information, and EVPI stands for Expected Value of Perfect Information. In practice, decision makers often have the ability to collect additional information about the states of nature. For example, having market research in the apartment complex example. These two terms are particularly useful when the decision makers try to consider the value of this additional information and how it can affect the decision process. In our revised apartment complex example, the optimal decision is to spend $100K on the market research. Depending on the outcome of the report, the company either builds a large or a small complex. Here are two questions for you to consider. First, what is the value of the market research? Is the report worth $100K? Second, if someone knows exactly what level of demand will happen in the future, how much will the company be willing to pay for such perfect information? These two questions can be answered using EVSI and EVPI. EVSI is the difference between the expected monetary value, EMV, with free information, and EMV without any additional sample or perfect information. EVPI is the difference between EMV with perfect information and EMV without any information. Once we have EVSI and EVPI, we can also calculate efficiency as their ratio. If the report produced from market research on future demand is close to perfect, then the efficiency is going to be close to 1. To calculate either EVSI or EVPI, we would need to calculate the EMV without any sample information first. That's the expected payoff without getting any additional information. Well, that's the EMV in the original single-stage apartment complex example. You may remember the EMV is $3.03 million. To calculate EVSI, we would need the EMV with free sample information. What we know is that after paying $100K for the market research, the company's EMV is $3.78 million. If the market research is completely free, the company's EMV is going to be $100K more. That's going to be $3.88 million. Therefore, the EMV with free sample information is $3.88 million. Once we have EMV with free sample information and EMV without any information calculated, we can calculate EVSI as $0.847 million. This means the answer to the first question, what the value of the market research is 847K. This is way more than 100K paid to carry out the market research. Let's calculate the last EMV, and that's the EMV with perfect information. This refers to the expected monetary value when we know for sure the states of nature, which means we know exactly what the future demand is going to be. There are three states of nature in this example, so we have to consider three different scenarios. First, if the demand is weak. If the demand is weak, the payoff would be $3 million for building a small complex and negative $0.3 million for building a medium complex and a negative $3.5 million for building a large complex. The company should definitely go with building a small complex and get the best payoff of $3 million. So that's $3 million here. If the demand is medium, the payoff is going to be $3 million for building a small complex, $4.7 million for building a medium complex, and $2.5 million for building a large complex. The company should definitely go with building a medium complex and get the best payoff of $4.7 million. Similarly, you can see that if the demand is large, The company should build a large complex and get the best payoff of $8.5 million. Let's summarize all the information together. We now have the alternative under each state of condition and their respective payoff as well. To calculate the EMV with perfect information, we would need to know the probability of having each state of nature. This is how likely the company will be informed of a weak demand, a medium demand, or a strong demand in the future. This company believes that the probability of being in any of those three states is exactly 1/3. So EMV with perfect information is going to be 3 million multiplied by 1/3, 4.7 million multiplied by 1/3, and 8.5 million multiplied by 1/3. That's going to be $5.4 million. We just calculated EMV without any sample or perfect information to be $3.033 million. With those two numbers, we can calculate EVPI to be $2.367 million. This implies that the value of the perfect information is $2.367 million. Here, I summarize all the information we have just calculated, including EVSI, EVPI. Efficiency can also be calculated using their ratio, and that's 35.78%. This number tells us how good the sample information is when compared to perfect information. An efficiency of 100% indicates that the information from market research is as good as the perfect information. Please pause the video here and review how each number is obtained if you haven't done so. In this video, we learned the two concepts EVSI and EVPI. EVSI measures the value of obtaining some sample information. If EVSI is higher than the cost of obtaining this sample information, it is worth obtaining the sample information. In our example, EVSI is $847,000, much higher than the cost of $100,000. So the company should definitely spend $100,000 for market research. On the other hand, assuming the EVSI is only $50,000, while it costs $100,000 to obtain some sample information, the company should not obtain the sample information. For EVPI, it sets an upper bound for the value of any sample information. Any sample information can't be better than the perfect information. In other words, sample information is at best as good as perfect information. The true value of any information should not be greater than the value of perfect information, which is $2.367 million. In our example, the company should not pay more than $2.367 million for any perfect or near-perfect information. This also concludes our video here.